Okay, so we are about to start building a user form in Excel, and that too with the help of VBA. So in order to create a data entry form, there should be one purpose. So in our case, I am going to take the purpose of creating a transaction register into this Excel workbook. Okay, so as you can see that I have just opened my Excel application. And currently I haven't even saved this Excel workbook, because you can see that the current name is book 1 only. So this is because I am going to start from the very beginning, so that we can understand everything step by step and there will not be any confusion or any queries in this video. So let's start. So before starting, first do one thing, let's do some formatting into our sheet. So for formatting, I am going to use my basic rules that you have also watched into another videos. So let's start doing this. First, I'm going to remove this grid line. So for this, I can use this shortcut Alt+WV, or I can simply go to this view tab and uncheck this grid lines from here. So when I will uncheck this from here, you can see that all the grid lines are gone now. Okay, so now as usual, I'm going to leave these two starting columns for some calculation purposes. It may or may not be used, but I usually leave them so that even in the near future, if I want to do some calculations over here for my VBA course, so it will help me. So now do one thing, select this, go to this data tab and click on this group option. So after that, it would be very much easy to open and close it, though it might cover some area over here as well. So we are going to start making our transaction register over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just giving some extra height to the first row, and after that I will select it up to here, do a right click and go to this format cells options. So when the format cell dialog box will appear into the screen, what I will do is I will just take it on the upside and go to this fill option over here, because I just want to give a gradient look to my Excel workbook. So I will go to this fill effects, and what I will do is I will choose a little bit darker color on the top and a lighter color on the bottom, and I will choose this variant, that is the top should be a little bit brighter and the lower should be a little bit lower bright over there, and I will press OK. So after this I am going to press OK, and you can see that this formatting is applied over here. After that, I am going to choose the same amount of columns along with some rows that I want. So let's say that I will select it up to 68 up to here, and what I am going to do is I am simply giving the cells the lighter color that I have chosen. So now this will give me a gradient look over here. So after this, I am going to type the heading, which is the transaction register in our case. Okay, so after transaction register is just written, what I will do, I will just make it a little bit bigger and give it a bold look. Also, I can choose any sort of other font that I might want to use into my formatting and all that things. So I think any of the format you can choose it from here. So let's let it to be default, or we can make it a little bit bigger as well. So our transaction register is headed over here. So now what we are going to do is we will simply give it a serial number, and we are about to make our headings over here. So the serial number, then I will type particulars over here. That will be the basic thing for which the expense is made or the income is received. After that, I can put some sort of numbering into it, but I have put it already over here, so I'm not going to do it. So there is a debit in rupees, and same is with the credit. So all the four headings are now prepared. What I can do is I can select them, simply click Alt+HOW into my keyboard and give them a perfect width. So I'm giving them 25, make it bold. And what I can do is I can just give it a heading look. So I will just give some height to this row as well, increase the text size and make it up to the middle alignment. So our transaction register is now over here. So I want to give it a report look, a little bit different from the entire background. So what I'm going to do is I will select it, simply go to the home tab, and in the color I can choose no fill, or I can do it by the shortcut Alt-HHN. After this, what I am going to do is I will do a right click, and after this right click I will go to the format cells option again, but this time I am not going to the fill, I am going to the border, and as the theme is orange I will choose a darker color and give these cells a dark background and a liner background in the middle. So now I will press OK. So you can see that my report is now perfectly looking. It is even appearing different from the background, and it can be printable as well. So now what we are supposed to do is we have to make a user form in order to enter data into it. So after the formatting of the files, let's start building our user form. Okay, so after formatting our sheet, the next step is to save this workbook. Okay, this is a very important step, because when we are about to work in a workbook that contains Visual Basic code in it, we cannot just save it as a normal Excel workbook. So in order to work in an Excel workbook that contains macro or that contains VBA code, we have to save it in a different format. So let's see what that format is. So when I am going to find or save this sheet, what I will do is I will go to this file option and simply go to the same procedure as save as. After that I will use this browse option. So after that you can see that this dialog is appear, and I am going to save this file into my main folder so that I can attach it later with the course. So what I am going to do is I will simply copy the path instead of going from here, and I will paste it over here. After this I will name it as the working file, or let's say that I will, instead of this I will type transaction recorder. Okay, so now you can see that currently my Excel workbook is going to be saved as an Excel workbook, which is the .xlsx format. But you have to note this, that whenever you are working in Metro, you have to change this and select the Excel macro enabled workbook in order to make it a workbook that can contain the Visual Basic coding in it. So I will save it. Now you can see that my file is saved and its name is changed to transaction recorder. Now if we go to my folder, you can see that the icon of this file is a little bit different. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show it by changing it to extra large icons. So if it is a normal Excel file, you know that this file and this X image is only there, but when we save it as a macro enabled workbook, this macro sign is also added with it. So you can see that this is a little bit different from the normal sheets. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this sheet first. So I will type, let's say, transaction recorder. After this, now we can work on creating the Excel form and the Visual Basic code that will make it work. So let's start that. Okay, so now we are moving towards creating the Visual Basic form and the codes, both of them together. So for this, you have to click on this developer tab over here. Now, but you can see that while opening Excel in your desktop or a laptop, you might not be able to see this developer tab over here because you had not worked it till now. So in order to make it visible, what you have to do is you have to go to this file option and you have to select this options menu. So when you will click on this, the Excel option dialog will appear. In this you have to go to this customize ribbon. So when I will click on it, you can see that this entire screen will be changed, and you can see that currently my developer tab is marked as I need it. So you have to make sure that this checkbox is selected. If this checkbox is not selected, so basically you will see a screen like this in which developer tab is not selected. So if I will press OK, you can see that the developer tab has been gone from here. So in order to make it visible, you have to go to this options and you have to click on customize ribbon and check this box so that this developer tab will get visible over here. Another way of doing it is to simply press the Alt-F11 shortcut so that you will directly redirect it to the Visual Basics option. You can see that the shortcut of this is Alt-F11. So I will click on it, and you can see that the Visual Basics screen is appearing right now in front of me, and we can see that the sheet 1 transaction recorder is over here. So if we want to write any sheet related code, we can write it from here. If we want to add any sort of workbook code, we can add this from here. But in our case, we are going to prepare a user form. So for this, what we have to do is we have to click on this insert option and we have to select this user form from here. So when I will click on it, you can see that currently nothing is visible over here. But when I will click on it, you can see that a different section named form is added and user form 1, which is this form. So this is appeared over here. So now we have to add our things into it. So first we will resize it to the size we want. And then we can add all the things that we want into it. So let's start adding those things. Okay, so you can see that while we have created this user form, we have got this toolbox along with this. So this is a very good thing. It will help us a lot in creating our entire design of the user form. But before that, I want to just show you something else. So when you will click on it in that user form, you can see that this property window is appearing over here. So we have the name of this form is user form 1, which is also appearing over here. So let's say that I do not want to name it as user form. I want to name it as transaction register. Let's say I will type regist only. So we have to make sure that in this name there will not be any space, because Excel will not accept any space over here. So let's say that I will type transaction register. So I will click over here and you can see that this name is changed. However, you can see that currently this user form is showing me user form 1 only. This has not been changed. So this is not changed because this is not the name of the user form. This is actually the caption. So in order to change this, we have to come over here into this caption option. You can see that currently it is user form 1 only. So I will delete it. So you can see that it is also removed from here as well. So let's say that I will type transaction recorder and I can give a space over here. So I can type transaction recorder and this is now currently appearing over here. So after this, what we have to do is we have to add all the fields and the labels and our buttons. So as we are creating a normal form in order to add data into it only. So what we want is we want to add 4 fields which can add data that we have to put over here and some command buttons that will tell us or tell Excel that what to do after adding that data. So what we are going to do is first we are going to add the labels. So what is label? I will show you in some time. So you can see that if you come into your toolbox, this A sign represent the label. So you have to click on it and when you will come on this on your user form, a plus sign will appear. So all you have to do is you simply have to create a rectangle or a square or whatever shape you want. So I have created it, so it is named as label 1. Also you can see that it is pure gray, it has not have this dotted lines with it. So now what I will do, just in order to make the shape and size of this label same, I will just simply copy it and paste it so that we have our 4 labels over here. So this is label, currently it is showing label 1 only because this is the copy paste. So we can change it later. But you can see that all these are coming and actually I don't need it. So right now I will delete it. So these 4 are coming, but you can see that they are not aligned properly. So I have to go to this format option and in this align, I will choose either left or right. So if I will choose right, so it is aligned from right and you can see that all these 4 are coming over here. Now what I will do is I will just do a little bit or give it a little bit of space so that they may look a little bit different from each other. So 2 lines gap is that all I want. So now what label is that simply it will tell the user what to add over here. So I will just do one thing, I will select them and make same size. So okay, so this is width, so I just want them a little bit small. So first selected and you can see that it is named as label 1, but we have to change the caption only. So what we are going to do is we will type this serial number over here. So now this is serial number. What we can do is we can select all these 4 and we can go to this font and click on this button so that a little bit font can be changed because this is too much small. So when we click on it, you can see that the font dialog is over here. So I will make them bold and make them a little bit bigger in size. Any format you can choose from here. So this is this will appear like this. So our next thing is particulars. So we will type particulars over here. Okay, so we will make it a little bit bigger. After this we have debit or credit amount. So I will select it and will type debit amount or debit rupees and credit rupees. Okay, so our labels are created. Now we have to make those things that will add us, that will help us in adding the data. So they will known as the text box. So I am selecting it and putting it over here. So this can be like this, and I will do the same thing. I will copy and paste it, put it over here. So I need this four signs. Okay, so they are now over here. I can just make sure that they are properly aligned. So I will align them to the right. So now these fields can be used to add the data. So I can add anything into it. What I can do is I can give them the same letters that I have given to it. So I will select it, go to this font place again. So basically this is appearing over here. I will click on this button, make this 16 and bold, and press OK. So after this, as this is appearing, so let's just play it. You can use this play button or can press F5 to make it visible how it looks. So I will click on it. So our form will look something like this till now. So we will close it and get back over here. So now let's say that we will add some data over here. So we have to tell Excel that whether to add that data or to delete that. So what for this we need some command button. So we have to search from where these command buttons are coming. So you can find that command button over here. So what you have to do is you can simply put it over here. So this is command button 1 and this can be the second one. So we need some buttons, so I will press them. Okay, so we need one button to add our transaction, one to update it, one to close the form, one to quit the form, and one to search it. And we can also need a table or something to search it. So what I'm going to do is I will simply select all of them and do the same thing, give them a font that may be visible. So I'm going to make that bold and 16. After this I will just simply change their text. So this can be to add the transaction, and this can be used for delete, or I can say update transaction, and this can be used for the quit option or close form. I can type close form into it, and the next thing is to simply maybe reset the form. And this button we are going to use it for the search command. So this will help us in searching the transaction that we have added. Okay, so they both are supposed to be together, so I am going to put it like this only, and these four are going to work together. So I will select them and will put it like this. Okay, so now our form is completed. So what I can do is I can simply play it again to see how this form looks. So it is looking pretty much well. You can see that we can add data over here and anything. So this is actually serial number, and transaction is, let's say that purchase debit rupees 20,000 and credit is nothing. So if I will click on this add transaction, you can see that nothing is working right now. So we have to make these buttons working. So now our form is prepared. We can move on to add some codes to make this form workable. So let's do this. So I am going to close it and we'll get back to our form. And now I am going to add the VBA codes into this to make this form working. Okay, so you can see that our form is prepared and we have to add some codes to make it working right now. But before that, I just want to share some other thing with you. Is that currently you can see that my form is looking pretty much well, but it is a common Excel form. I want to make it a little bit different, that is to look it pretty much like a modern sort of form. So for this, what we can do is we can add some background in back of this, because Excel do not provide us much things to add in the background, what we can do is we can simply change the border color and the back color over here, you can see. But the best thing that Excel has provided us is to add a picture into the background of this dash in this form. So for this, I have a small hack with me. So for this, basically I just use the PowerPoint application to create a good sort of background for my Excel forms that you must have seen into my different forms. So I will click on this PowerPoint and you can see that a new workbook is opened, or a new presentation is opened actually. So let's go into it, and in the blank presentation you can see that I have some sort of designs, but I want to create my own. So first let's add a blank sheet. So we are going to add a blank sheet and delete this previous one. So in this we can just simply go to design screen for us. So what I will do is I will simply select this rectangular option and will add it as a background. Now what I will do is I can go to this formatting option, which you can see that appearing only after selecting it. So I will go to this format, and after going into this option, basically I have got some things which is known as shape fill and outline. So I am going to make it no outline and basically no color. So you can see, you can say that why I have added this if I don't want to add any sort of thing over here. So this is because that if I don't add this background and will create an image, so PowerPoint, when I will export the image from this presentation, it will not give any sort of background into that image. So let's do one thing, let's make it a little bit small so it will be easy to select. Or till our image is not completed, we can give it a color so that it will be easy for us to select it. Okay, so now you can see that we have added some labels into it. So for this, what I am going to do is I am going to simply add the text box and will add them over here. So the first one is the serial number. So actually PowerPoint gave us a lot of ways to design our things, so this is sort of very good thing to add something into your background. So I will select this, make them a little bit big, and this is all right. After this, what I am going to do is I will simply copy and paste it, put it over here and name it as the particulars. After that, again I will copy and paste it and we'll put it like this and give it the debit amount, and the next one will be of course the credit amount, which is our fourth field. So you can add any sort of field that you want. So I am just adding only four because I think that it is enough. After that, what I am going to do is I can just simply place some lines over here in order to make a place for my data, or I can just leave it like this. So this is not something really big. After that, I can add some buttons that we have added over here. So for the buttons, I want to show you again that in the shapes I will choose this rounded corner rectangle. So this is because this look pretty much good. So let's make our button based on our theme. So we are going to choose the orange one. So I will choose a button like this and will type in this add, or I can type add transaction, but let's make it add only so that we can make it a little bit big. So we can make it look like this. After that, this will be the next button, will be update. So let's delete it, type update, and we need two more buttons. So make it like this, a little bit smaller, and also that text we can just simply make it reset form. And the next button will be quit or close form. So we will type close form. Okay, so now you can see that all our four buttons are prepared. What I can do is I can also give different colors to this. That is that into add, what I can do is I can give it a green color because this will represent add. Then in the reset, I can give it a blue color. So I will give it blue. In the close form, we can move on to something which is a bit red. So as red is not over here, let's select it from the shape fill. So let's give it, or we can leave it orange as well. In the update, we can give it a different color. So let's give it the gray one. Okay. So now our buttons are prepared. So basically this is something which is little bit harder to do in Excel. So you can use PowerPoint. This, it will always work and give you a good sort of background for your forms. After that, so these buttons are prepared. Now we have to make another label for search. So let's copy and paste it and put it over here. So this is basically our search, and we can make it small, leave some space for the text box, and after that we can add another box over here which will help us in searching the transaction. So we can name it as search as well. Okay. Also we can insert some icons into it. So we will click on this icon, but just make sure that your internet is connected, because this will work only when your network is there. So it is actually taking some time to load the icons. So let's do one thing, I will add the icons and then I will start this video. So let's. So I have added the icons and also some illustrations into it so that I can make it a little bit beautiful. So you can see that I have made this thing a little bit up and make a separate column for search. Okay, so now I have to make some changes accordingly, and will for this I am going to put my buttons into this line. So this is basically add, and I will take them a little bit to the lower side. We'll put update as the next button, and into the update I will make sure that this is put over here. The reset would be the next one, and then the close form button should also be there in the alignment. So I will put it over here. After this you can see that this these all shapes are here. So let's do one thing, first put them along with their button. So let's put it over here like this. Okay, so with add we have this over here. The reset can be with this button. Okay, so let's see what are the alignment of this, and we can make the all the shapes with that. So let's make it 1.33 and reset would be like this. So let's make this close to 1.33 centimeter as well. So delete this form and put it over here. For the search as well, we can make it to 1.33 only. 1.33 centimeter is actually helping us. So we can put it either here or here. So let's put it like this. And then what we can do is we can select all of these shapes and we'll color them as like this, so that it will be visible as the shape. Okay, we can delete him, he is not required, and we have forget for the update. So let's click on the icon if it is visible too quickly. And what icon we can use for update? S2. So we can use, though it can be used for refresh, but let's insert it right now. So first we will make it as 1.33, then put it over here. So you can also download these icons, some sort of icons from the internet as well. So I will add this update. Okay, so now this is done. Now I have to enter a background. So I will go to the shape and will select this entirely, right click on it and click on this send to back. Okay, let's do one thing. We can give a little bit background color too. So I think this can be good. Okay, so now I think my form is prepared. Let's do one thing. Let's remove this outline. So now in order to save it as an image, we have to do one thing. We have to press Ctrl A and then do a right click and click on this save as picture option. Okay, so now we have to select our folder. So let's do the same thing. We will just simply add our path over here and name it as the background. So I'm going to attach all this stuff so that you can also use it. So you have to make sure that this should not be saved as PNG, because Excel form accept only JPEG format. So what JPEG will do, JPEG will actually diminish the quality of this, but it we have no other option instead of adding the JPEG file only. So let's do one thing. We will go to this form and we will make a copy of it. So let's do one thing, just simply copy it, and I think we should have an option to copy and paste it as well. Or we can add a new form as well in order to enter whatever we want. So let's make it a little bit big and just make sure that this picture would be fit into the background. So this is a real challenge. Just to fit it, as you can see that it is too much big, it is not coming into the background. So let's do one thing, let's resize our image first. So in order to resize our image, we can go to the place where we have saved it, select our image, do a right click, and what we can do is we can simply open it with the paint, because paint actually help us to resize it very quickly and it will also do it with less working. So we are actually opening it with paint. So let's do one thing, go to this view option and I think resize is coming into the home only. So let's do one thing, make this 50 and press OK. I think we have to do it again because the image is actually coming too much big. So this is 50 and 50, or let's just undo it, because I want to see that whether it is coming or not. Save our path over here. So we have to copy it again from here and we can paste it over here. So this will be background 2. Okay, now we can go to our form. In this picture we are going to select background 2 this time. So you can see that this is almost coming. So what we can do is we can resize it to 80 only, because 50 will be too much small. We can save it and again go to this and select our background 2. So actually this is coming, though we can make it, whether we can make it 100 again or not. Let's check this. Okay, so we can make it 100. It is actually working. So you can see that this is another way of creating the user form. I can name it as a transaction register, just to give it a little bit different name. And if we play it, so you can see that this form is looking actually very much good than the previous one. We can see our previous form as well. So this is looking like this, and our new form is actually looking like this. So we can remove these gray corners as well. These are coming like this. So we have to just resize it to the image only, and then only the image will appear. So I think this form is looking pretty much good. So let's do one thing, change its caption to transaction register. So I have actually tell you how to make your form look a little bit good as well, so that it will add up to your skills. Now let's do one thing. We do not have to add the label because we have added it in the PowerPoint. We have to add the check text boxes only. So first add our text boxes. So they should be here because the data we have to put in Excel. So we have to make sure that the data requirement should be fulfilled. After this, we can add it over here, and the next one over here. Okay. So after selecting all these four, let's see if we can change this back color to not visible or something. So we have this. Okay, so by using this style, actually the image is also not disappearing. So let's save it and let's play it to see how it works. Okay, so now this is looking really good. Now we have to do that again. We have to select this all thing, go to this font and make sure that it is selected to 16 or 18 so that it will look a little bit big. Okay, now when I will save it and play, so you can see that the data is actually adding over here. Okay, so this is purchase, debit amount again 20,000, but you can see that when I am clicking on this add, even it is not clickable. Though in our previous form, in this form that we have created only in Excel, we can at least click these buttons. So I am telling you this because though we have given the formatting and all stuff over here in the PowerPoint, but we have to put the actual Excel buttons. So as we have actually added these text boxes, so like this we have to add the command button as well. So let's do one thing, make them to be on the top of this image. Let's copy and paste it. Again, put it over here. So you might be thinking that why I am doing this, because I have done so much work in order to make this button look good, but now I am doing the same thing. I am making them as equal as the Excel buttons that we have used earlier, but there is actually something hidden into this trick. So now you can see that our buttons are covered with these command buttons, but this time I'm not going to format it because I don't need this view of these buttons. So I will simply select this, go to this properties window again, and in the back color, type, I am going to select the same that I have selected for these text boxes over here. But you can see that this text is actually coming. So let's select it and delete this text so that it won't be visible. So what it actually do, though our buttons are there, but they are not visible. So the background that we have made into the Excel only, so that background is visible to us, so that all our formatting will is actually coming to work when we put these sort of options. Okay, so let's don't make it that much big, because we have to make the reset button as well. Okay, now I am actually making sure that the white line won't come on my button, which is an overlapping line. So let's make it like this. This is going too much big, so make it small. So our purpose is just to make sure that this won't be visible. So let's, if I will play it, you can see now that these buttons are now clickable. We can do some working on it because they are actually showing right now. So let's do one thing, inactive borders. Okay, so make it into the middle and then see how that button is looking. Okay, so they are looking cool. We have to make some work into the close only and the search. Okay, so now these buttons are clickable again. So we have created this good looking form again, but we have to add the quotes in order to make this form workable. So let's copy it again, because we have to put something in order to search over here. Okay, so now if we will save it and play it, so I have this search option as well. So let's start adding our code now. Okay, so now our form is prepared. We have added the design as well. Now we are moving toward adding the VBA code. So I'm going to start from the smaller one, so that some smaller codes will be done very easily, and we will get plenty of time and also remaining power to understand the bigger one as well. So let's start with the close button. So in order to add the code, what we are going to do is we will simply do a double click on this button, and Excel will take us to the place where we have to add our code. First we will type the comment to remember why we have created this, to close the form, and we will simply type unload me and save it. So if I will go to the form and will play it as usual as we are doing it, so now I do not have to use this close button. I can simply click on this one and the form got closed. So now the close button is completed and we can move on to creating the next code. Okay, so after assigning the VBA code to close the form, the next step is to move on to the next button. So the next button we can take is the reset one, because this is also going to be a little bit a small VBA code. So let's say that I will type over that this code is just for reset the VBA form. So in this, what we are going to do is I just want to show you practically, is that when we play this form, let's say I type some data over here, though it is serial number, but I am just typing it. So let's say I will close it and start it again. So you can see that the data is gone. The data that I have typed is not over here. So what I can do is that instead of writing that all the fields should be blank, what I can do is I can simply type unload me, which is just to close the form, and then trans register dot show. So you have to type your form name over here, so make sure that your form name should be correct, because otherwise this is not going to run. So let's say that if I will go over here and simply play it, so let's say that I will type any data over here and just click on reset. So you can see that it has followed the same procedure. What it has done, it has first closed the form and then play it again. So that's how my data got reset. Another way to reset it is, I just also want to show you that as well, because I don't want that you will see that this is some sort of a simple VBA code. So I just want to show you another way, because in some case might be this not work. So what you can do is that instead of this, so I currently made them as a comment only, so this code won't work. So what we have to do is we have to simply double click over here and take this name. Now after taking this, we can simply copy it and paste it over here. So we can type text box 1.value is equal to blank, and same what we can do is we can simply copy it and paste it, because we have around 4 boxes over here, so the name would be text box 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I can simply save it, and if I will go over here and let's say I will play it, so if I will type anything over here, Anshuman, and let's say it is Tandon, so if I will reset it, you can see that the form doesn't got closed and it won't start it again. What it has done, it has simply make all these 4 fields data as nothing. So if I will click on it, you can see that it is reset. So if you don't want that blink which we have got into our previous code, so you can try this one as well. So I have told you both types of code for this. So the first one is you can use it for simply just close the form and then open it again, or you can simply make your boxes value equal to blank. So what I'm going to do is I will just type it and will type first code over here, so that when you will use this file, it will be easy for you to identify that they are 2 separate codes, and this one is second code. So we have seen both types of code over here. You can play any of them. This one will give you a blink. Just that is the only difference over here. Okay, so now we are going towards our next codes, which I am going to take the one which will help us to add the value from the form to our Excel sheet. So let's do one thing. First, we will remove it because we don't want it. We just had take this for the name of our text box. Then we can go to this transaction register, and you can see that we had done these two options. Now we are going towards this add one. So let's click it. So you can see now that our command button one click is prepared over here. So I'm giving some space to it so that we can see it clearly. Okay, so I just don't just want to get you in the situation in which you will just remember this code. So I am going to teach you all the things one by one. Also, by using such types of comment, I am going to add whatever the reason for which I have added that particular code. Okay, so first we are going to towards our transaction register. So this is our Excel sheet in which we had prepared this, and we want that whenever we add data into this VBA form, that will, when I will press this add, it will automatically got over here. And things which we have to worry about is that some data that we want should not be overlapped, and it will automatically identify the row number in which it has to paste the data. So let's see how we are going to do this. So I am again going over here. So whenever we are going to write some sort of big VBA code in which we have to define some parameters, what we have to do is we have to define some variables first. So in order to define a variable, you have to use the text as dim, and you can give it any name. So let's say that if I will give it the name as range, or I can simply give it rows so that you can understand it better. So whenever we are going to refer to a range, we have to use it as long. So we are defining a range as the name of row. So what I have done over here is you can see that these three things got blue, but this has got black only. This is because this code is just to define that we are going to put a range over here, and this is the basic code to determine a variable, and this is the name that we have given to that variable. Now after determining the range, we have to go to the sheet, because there can be multiple sheets in our workbook. So what I am going to do is I will type dim and sheet as, or I can simply give it a small name, worksheet as worksheet. Okay, so now you can see that we have identified all the parameters. So I will type a comment over here that is used to define the parameters. Okay, now we are moving toward the next step, which is to give these parameters some sort of value. So the first thing is our worksheet. So we will type worksheet, or for giving it some value, we have to type set worksheet is equal to sheet 1. So there are two ways of doing it. If you don't want directly to type the sheet 1, you have to type sheet and then open the bracket and give it something like this. So what it will do, it will focus on the name of the worksheet. So if this is a bad code, because if in future you will rename this sheet, so you have to change your code again and again. So instead of doing this, what I have done is I have simply referred this as sheet 1, because now it know that we have to focus on sheet 1, which is the base sheet 1. If we rename it, so that doesn't matter. So we are simply defining it as sheet 1. Now we have to move to our row. So now I am telling Excel that which row it has to take. So for row, we have to type worksheet dot range, because I have told you that we are going to give this name to a range only, and we will open the bracket. Now we have to come back to our Excel workbook, because we have to see that which column we has taken. So it is D. So we will give it a reference in the double apostrophe comma, and rows dot count bracket close dot and xl up dot row. So I am going to tell you everything that I have typed. So first we have typed this row which we have defined as a parameter over here. Then we have gone to the worksheet in which we have to work. So we are telling Excel that a way to choose the row automatically, because let's say if I will just add some data over here in the first row of our register, so then the next row will be the fifth one, and if we add some data over here, the next one will be six. So it is going to be a dynamic row. So we cannot just tell Excel that paste everything in this row only. So we have done a coding by which Excel will do something so that it will automatically recognize the last row. So how it is going to do, let's discuss that. So we have typed row equals to worksheet, which is the sheet 1. So Excel will go to our sheet 1, which is named as transaction repo. Dot range. So we are telling that in this worksheet, Excel has to select a range. So that range should start with the D. So we have identified the column because this is going to be the same. And rows count. So what Excel will do, Excel will count all these rows. After this, when Excel will count all the rows, it will automatically direct it to D1048576, which is the last row of the Excel worksheet. After that, it will stop for a second and do an Excel up. So what is Excel up is, if I will press Control up from here, you can see that I will be redirected to the last used row. And after that, we have defined this dot row. So what is it is this, what Excel will do, Excel will come to this worksheet, go to the last row, and then press Control up to go to the last row which is used. So this is how we have defined our row. After that, so I just want to put some comment over here as well so that you will remember. So this is to defining the parameters that we have set into the above space. Okay, so now we have to do something to make our data displayed into the sheet or to transferred into the sheet. So we are going to add a code to transfer data into the sheet. So after this, what we have to do is we have to simply make the value of this cell, that means the selected row, that row which Excel will select from our code. So we have to make sure that the row which Excel has selected, so in its column D, E, F and G, the value should be equal to our VBA form text box, to these four text boxes. So I will simply type a small code over here, which is dot cells. So you can see that I am referring to cells, because over here we have defined the range. So in this range, now we have to focus on the cells only, that which cells Excel has to select. So before typing it, we have to type with worksheet. So why we had done this? We had done this so that Excel won't move to any other sheet that might be created into this register. So we will type dot cells row plus one. So why I have did this row plus one? So as I have told you earlier about this code, so what it will do, it will simply go to the D column, go to the last cell which is 1048576. So this is going to be our last row, then do an Excel up. So what Excel will select? Excel will select the last used row, which is our heading. Now if I won't add one into it, Excel will type my data over here only, and it won't work like this, like going into like this. So if I will select plus one, so what Excel will do, that after it will select the row which is last used, it will add one and come into the fourth one. When it will add data into fourth one, what it will do, that by doing the Excel up, it will go to fourth one and then plus one into it, so that always the next blank row will be selected. So what I have done, cells row dot one, sorry, row plus one comma, then we have to select the first column which is D in our case, close the bracket, and value dot value. So I have to type value over here equals to, so what is our what are our text boxes, so we can copy their name from here only. So this message is appearing again and again because I am just skipping the code from the middle. So this is going to be the code which will add our data into the text box. So what we will do, we will make four copy of it because we have four text boxes. In case you have more than four boxes, then what you can do, you can edit as much type as you want. So I have changed this to DEFG because the data is supposed to be go like this, and the text box one should be changed. So this is going to be 2, this is 3, and this is 4. Okay, so this will help us to add our data into the worksheet, and then we will type end with over here. So what this code has done, this code will help us to transfer the data into the sheet. Okay, so now let's see how this is going to work. So if I will go ahead and play this form, so let's say that I will type serial number 1, particular should be purchase of goods, or you can simply type purchase over here. Then debit amount should be 20,000 and credit should be nothing. So let's say if I will type add, so you can see that when I have plus it, something has happened, and what has happened is that all the data has been appear over here, but you can see that the data is still over here as well. Either I should reset it, or if I will press add again, what Excel will do, Excel will add into the next column, which can result to an error. So in order to make sure that, either what you can do is you have to make sure that this reset should be pressed again and again, or what we can do is we can simply add some code into our add button only, so that this data will automatically got removed. So for this I am going to type a comment again, that is to reset the form after data entry, or you can type, in our case this is transaction entry. So what is this, is we simply add the reset code that we have typed over here. So you can either do this one, or you can simply copy this one and paste it over here. So now I will just remove the extra spacing that I have, and now if we go to our form and place it, so let's say that if I will type 2 and this is going to be sale, so sale is going to be of 40,000. So if I will add it, you can see that the data has got add over here, and also it got disappeared from here as well, so that all such type of mistakes will be removed. So now let's do one thing, let's delete this data. Now you can see that our add button is now working. So this is a very simple code. I have tried to make it as simple as possible, and I had taught you every step in detail so that you do not have to just remember this code again and again. You can simply learn it and you can apply it anywhere you want. Okay, so now we have to move towards the next button, so let's do that. Okay, so our next button can be this update only, but what I just want to show you is that I just want to show you the search VBA code first. So I am doing it for a reason, and the reason is that if you will learn how to search, the update will be just for a second only, and I think that I can teach you this search button very easily. So what we are going to do is we will just double click on it so that we will be redirected to the VBA code space over here, and we have to search our data. So before searching, let's do one thing, let's add some data over here. So let's play this form, and I can just put it over here so that you can see how the data entry is going on. So this is going to be a purchase, and purchase will be going to be of 20,000. So just add it, then the second serial number, this is going to be sale, and this is for 40,000. Let's add it. Let's do one thing, let's add third one. So this is going to be a purchase amount again. So let's say that this will be 22,000. So add it, and the fourth one will be any sort of expense. So this will code 4800. So let's add it as well. So now you can see that we have added some data over here. Let's do one thing, let's save this file, and after that we can go into our VBA form only in order to add the search VBA code. Double click on it so that we will be redirected over here. So first, as in every code, I have told you that the first step is to add the parameters. So let's add them. So I am typing a comment that it is to define the parameters. Okay. Now we have to define some parameters over here. So first I am going to define the row which Excel has to take. So this is going to be the row. Then worksheet as worksheet. Okay, then I am going to type the dim search row as long. So this is because the addition in this code is that we have to make a search row as well, which will match the data that we want to search. Okay, now we are doing the next thing, which is to set the parameters. So I can also type defining values. So let's do one thing, let's give some space so that it will come on the upward and you can see it clearly. So this is defining the values. So we can simply give it something which is going to be as same as the add thing. So let's do one thing, let's copy this so that we do not have to type it again and again. So I am just copying it from Control C and pressing it over here by using Control V option, so that it will, the data got pasted. And the next one is the third thing that we have defined. So for this we have to type that for y is equal to, so let's see that how much row we have given over here. So we have given three rows up to the heading. So we have to type 3-2 row. So this row will be the one that we have defined over here. And after this, we have started a for. So we will type that if sheet 1, or we can simply type the worksheet. So we have to make sure that this H won't be here. So if worksheet dot cells, we have to type S row over here because we have defined the name as S row. So this is cells S row comma 1 dot text. So this should be equals to our text box 1. So this error is coming and again and again. I think that you know it, why it is coming. So we have to copy it and paste it over here, but there is some sort of difference over here. So this is going to be text box 5. This is because in our VBA form we have this text box to search the data and its name is text box 5. So let's go again to the search button VBA code. So what I have done, I will just first let me write it, then I will define everything over here. So then what it will do is that it will simply, I can just copy it so that I do not have to type very much again and again. So we will copy it and this will be equals to worksheet dot cells s row comma 1. Okay, so now we have to do one thing, we have to simply copy it and delete this one, make sure that this is 2 because this is going to be our the second column, then this will be 3 and this will be 4. Okay, so now we have to close this if that we had made. So I'm going to type end if over here, then next s row. Okay, so now I just want to tell you what I have done over here. So first I have defined some parameters. I have taken row as a range and then I take worksheet as my worksheet in which I am going to work, and s row is the one that will be appearing into the search. because let's say that if I will search sale or if I will search this two, because this you can see that this can be duplicate but this won't. So let's go with the serial number. So let's say I have typed two. So row will be all the rows that we have defined over here, but S row will be the one that will match with the data that I have entered. Okay, after that we had defined it. First we had shared the worksheet to sheet one, then the row to the same, which is going to be the last used. And what we have done with the S row is that it is going to be 3 to row. For example, let's say that by row, what Excel will do, Excel will come over here, and S row will be the row that will move from 3 to the last row that is selected. So Excel will select this all area, then this is going to be the code to help us to search the data. So this is search code. So what I have done, first I have defined some variables, then I made Excel to go to the last row which is used, and then I have set the search row to the from the third one to the last one which will be selected in our case. And then what I am saying that if in this cell the S row 1 data, that means this one, is equal to text box 5 text that I am going to add in the search. So let's say if I will type 2, so that one which is equal to 2, so if it is equal to 2, what Excel is going to do, Excel will make the value of these text boxes equal to the value that is entered into that particular row in the four columns. So I have told Excel that if the data entered into the text box is equal to any sort of row which we have selected, and our selection is this, so if any row is equal to the data that I have entered, so what you will do, pick data from here and paste it into the text box that are appearing into my VBA form. After this I had made this if close, and next S row is this, because like if we are seeing over here and this data is small, so we can identify that the second one is over here, but Excel cannot identify it like this. So it has to go, it has to check the first row. So if it match, it is okay. Excel will do one thing, if it got matched, Excel will fill the value. However, if it won't match, Excel will move on to the second row. So for this we have typed next S row. So this is how our data is going to be searched. So I am deleting this extra space and I am saving it. So let's do one thing, let's play this form. So let's say if I will type 2 and I will search it, so you can see that currently nothing is going on. So this might be happen because we have some error into our VBA code. So let's see that what error we have done. So first we have identified the parameters, then the next thing that we have done is the making that, giving that or assigning that parameter some value. After this I can make sure that this can be 4, because we have started our data from 4 only, and we have to make sure that this is going to be something else as well, because the data that we are going to add should be in the row and column number can be 4 as well. So let's do one thing, let's check what we have added into the search one. So we have typed row plus 1 comma d, so we can either type d over here or we can make it 4 as well. So let's do one thing, make it 4 5 6 or 7. Okay, so now if we are going to play this again, let's type 2 over here and let's see what will happen. So you can see that the data is now searchable. This has happened because like we have hidden these two columns and make this C unused. So Excel is searching into the A column. So in A column, as there is no data, so no search is coming over here. So we have defined that search from the fourth column only, and this fourth column has this serial number. So Excel has done, what Excel has done is Excel will go to the first row, will search it, as 2 doesn't match to 1, it will move on to the second one. And when second one is over here, so as this value is matched, Excel has picked up this value. So you can see that this value is exactly same from what we have entered. This is 2, then sale, then the next column is blank and the next one is 40,000. So Excel has copied that data from here and put it over here. So what we have done simply in the add, we had copied data from here to this, and in the search we have copied data from this to this, from the worksheet to form. There is just one addition, that is to select the row to which this data match that we have entered into this search box. So for this we had to, just in order to add this one different condition into our VBA code, what we have done is we have just defined the third variable and give it a value and told Excel that if that value matches, so pick up that data only in that case. So this is how our search works. So now we can move on to the update VBA code as well. So for the update VBA code, you can simply see that this is going to be very easy because the search one is done and I can make sure that the update button won't gonna do some headache to you. So let's double click it so that we can move on to the command button to click. Let's copy it and do one thing that I have told you that this is going to be same. So just simply let's copy this VBA code and paste it over here into the command button to click. Okay, so let's paste it and you can see that command button to click is now have the same code as search. So what we have to change simply is that if that data, so what we have done, I have to open the form in order to tell you or explain you easily. So what we have done in search, we tell Excel that if data entered into this text box in which I am writing right now match any sort of data that is coming into this D column, so do one thing, copy that row and paste it one by one into this VBA form, that is copy the serial number, paste over here the particular, the debit at the credit cell. Now in the update we have to make sure that if the data of this cell, so because after updating this search won't have any usage, so if the data entered into this serial number match any of this, so do one thing, that paste it again into that row only and do not paste it to the last row that is going to be work. So how to make this little change over here? So what we have defined, this worksheet to sheet one that is going to be same, row to the last row that is going to be same, and you can make it to update row because this is not the search row, so your row is going to be the same as well. So what in update code, so I can make it update. In update code the simple change is that if worksheet cells euro.4 is going to match the textbox 5. So we have written textbox 5 over here because we are searching from this, but we have to make sure that in update the data won't match this, data will match this search box only. So we have to change this 5 to 1. So if this text is equal, do one thing, that in the search what we have done is, if I will go over here and play it again to show you, in search what we have done, we have copied data from here and paste over here, but in the update what we have to do is we have to reverse it, we have to copy data from here and paste it over here. So let's do that. We simply have to do one thing, we have to copy this and paste it over here, and we have to remove this one, then we can cut this, paste it over here, then we can cut this and paste it over here, because we are reversing the mechanism that we had followed. The mechanism is absolutely same, just a simple reversal and assignment to a different text box only. Okay, so everything is going to be same as it is. So let's do one thing, let's check that whether all of our codes are working or not. So let's say I am entering the data to serial number 5, so that is going to be a miscellaneous income which will amount to 8,800 rupees. So let's see, actually this form got a little bit big, so it is not appearing. So I'm showing you half only, and I will make sure that I will make change in this area only. So let's add it. So when I have added 5, it should got added into the last row. I will press add and you can see that the data is added. Now if I will search this one, I have to type 5 and search it. So you can see that the same data has appeared over here again. And let's say that if I have to change this spelling only and I have to update it. Okay, so this is a little bit different because we have defined it as euro and we have not changed it into this last one only. So this is the actual magic. You can see that what Excel has done is that when I have searched this 51 and changed this income to income only, or so what Excel has done, Excel has searched it up to the first row, but as you can see that their SRO is written and SRO is not defined in that variable, so it doesn't know that what I have to do in the next step, so it has given me an error. Though when I have typed euro, so it will go to the next one only. So if I will press update, you have to focus over this area, so this is income, and so I have to change it to INM. So if I will update, okay, there is another error. So what this is, worksheet. Okay, so in the copy paste I have forget to change this euro to every places, so you have to make sure to this, don't make this mistake. So let's do one thing, let's again search this 5 and search it over here and change this income to INM only. So if I will press update, please just focus over this area because this is going to be changed. So you can see that this is changed. So what Excel has done, Excel has searched first one, so this won't match, leave it. Go to the second, this won't match, leave it. And Excel has done this to every row, and when 5 got matched, it has changed it. So let's say that if I will type income again and update it, so this will change accordingly. But you, as you can see that after updating, even this data is existing over here. So we either have to make sure that this reset would be placed, or we can do one thing is that we can simply add that code to remove the data after the updation, remove the transaction. Okay, so we have to add some VBA code over here. So that is going to be the same one as reset. So if you want to make it automatic, you can add it. If you don't want to make it automatic, just make sure that reset button will be added. So let's do one thing, let's change the second one. So in order to change, if I will put data over here and press search, so this is not going to work. So in order to make sure that this will work, so I have to search it from here. So in 2, the same data is added over here, and if we make it to 48,000 and just update it, so I have to make sure that this 48,000 should be visible to you. So just update it, and the data got pasted and it has been removed from here. So we have learned everything relating to that particular VBA form. We have learned how to add data by using a VBA form to the worksheet. We have also learned how to search any data that we have added earlier, and also how to update any sort of data that we had entered. So we can do it. I hope you have learned everything regarding it. I have also to tell you these two simple codes, that is to reset and to close the form. So now there might be one question in your mind that either I have to go to this VBA virtual basic area again and again and press it to and press play to play it again and again, or what we can do is we can simply add some sort of control over here. So for this, let's do one thing, go to this insert tab and go to this illustration, and in this shape you have to select this rounded corner rectangle. So we have a lot of training like this in our website excelmanindia.com. you can search it from the course menu. So we have to type the transaction entry, or we can type any name, you can simply type show form. So you can see that it is not very much similar to our theme. So in order to make it quick, you can simply go to this format option, which is actually appearing when I am selecting this shape. If I will deselect it, you can see that this option got removed from here. So I have to go into this format. So this will help us to quickly add some data, or so quickly add some formatting basically. So I have added it. Now in order to make this text, and so I have giving them a middle alignment and make it a little big. So now what I have to do is I have to assign it a macro. So let's do one thing, go to the virtual basics form again, go to this insert and add module. So this is just to show the form. Okay, so we have to start our VBA code from sub. So I am typing sub show form sh form, and you can see that end sub is automatically coming. So I have to make sure that this trans register got appeared. Okay, so this is how we have added. So we have also added this in the reset one, so I think you have it is very easy for you to learn. Now we have to simply assign it to this button. So let's select it by doing a right click, go to this assign macro option, and over here you will see the VBA code that we have assigned to it, and we will press OK. So if I will click on it now, you can see that the form is appearing. I can close it and open it again as much as I want. So I have told you every sort of a step that you have to learn in order to make a VBA form. I hope you like this course, and if you like this course, do subscribe to our other courses as well. I just want to make sure that we will grow our Excel skills together. Thank you very much.